And now we will learn how to record sales receipts. This means getting paid from our customers immediately. For example, let's imagine on January 11, Vonda did 10 video hours for Alan and received payment immediately. In this example, we're also imagining the money was directly deposited into the bank. What will be the result in the trial balance if the receipt is $3,000? Well, if we look at the trial balance right now, we see video income is $14,400. But if we do a video job for $3,000 more, then what will video income become? Well, video income should increase by $3,000 and become $17,400. And that's the number we expect to have after we create the sale receipt. What do you think cash and bank will become? Well, cash and bank is $3,680. But if we receive $3,000 more into the bank account, what do you think the result should be? That's right, $6,680. Let's go ahead and record the receipt. Click on the plus sign, and under the column of customers, click sales receipt. Sales receipt. That's the appropriate place to go when you're getting paid immediately. Now, it said that the customer was Alan. So we choose Alan, and it said the date was January 11. I'm going to double check that in a second, but I'm pretty sure it's January 11. Yes. Now, what did we do on January 11? By the way, we want to make sure it's deposited directly into Chase Bank, and we'll deal with checks, credit card swipes, and cash later. But in this case, the particular service was video, and the quantity was 10. So as you can see, we now have a $3,000 sale receipt. Now, after I click save, let's check if the numbers in the trial balance are what we expect. Yes, they are. Cash and bank became $6,680 and video income became $17,400. Now, you may well ask, will it affect the customer's balance? And the answer is no. We got paid immediately. That means if we look at the reports that we set up and we open the customer balance detail, we will not, I repeat, we will not see that sale receipt anywhere on the customer balance detail because it does not affect the customer's balance. So then the question is, what report should we look at if we want to see sales receipts sorted by customer? And the answer is the sales by customer detail. Now, the way to open that is click reports. Okay, make sure you click all reports. And then the category there would be review sales. Now we have all sales reports and we can click sales by customer detail. And if we do that, we should, by the way, if you do that, the reason I see nothing is because my date range is dated in July and all of my transactions were in January. So I have to click the time period here and click all dates and run report. Now I can see the report for all dates. And if you look at Alan, you can see every sale. The first three were invoices and the last one was this sale receipt. If you need to see it or change it, you could double click and come right back to the sale receipt and you could do anything you want. You can change some amount. You can put on a message, add a memo, or change it the way we learned how to change it before in order to correct it. And if we did change the quantity, rate, or anything that affected the money amount, all the other reports would change immediately. Now, just for good measure, let's do a second example. Let's imagine on January 12, Vonda did 10 editing hours for Betty and received payment immediately. The money again was directly deposited into the bank. Now, what will be the result in the trial balance if the receipt is $1,400? Well, editing income will become, well, editing income before this is $7,420. Now, we just did another editing job. So it will become, that's right, $8,820. And what will cash in bank become? Well, cash in bank should become $8,080 if you add $1,400 to the existing balance of $6,680. So now how do we do this? Go to the plus sign, go all the way to the left, and choose sale receipt. Now again, it's January 12th, 10 editing for Betty. Betty is the customer. The date is January 12th, and the service we gave, or Vonda gave, was editing. And it was, I believe, 10 editing, making a $1,400 sale receipt. If I squash it in here, you can see it's a $1,400 sale receipt. Now, all we have to do is click Save, and we get our confirmation message. Close the receipt. Now the numbers in the trial balance are exactly what we expected, $8,080. And $8,820. And where else can we find this particular sale receipt? Well, we could double click cash in bank, and we could find the sale receipt that way. Here it is. These are the two sale receipts that got recorded in cash in bank. How else could we find this sale receipt? Well, if we click if we go back in the back arrow and we go back to the trial balance, you could also find this very same sale receipt in editing income by double clicking. And you can see these other editing jobs were invoiced, but this last one on the 12th for $1,400 was with a sale receipt. Let's click back. Now, where else can we see it? That's right. If we click reports and we go to all reports, and the category is review sales, sales by customer detail will show you all the receipts and all the invoices by customer. It's not showing anything now because we have the report dated in July. But if we put all dates and run the report, you can see now that Alan's receipt shows up in Alan's section and Betty's receipt shows up in Betty's section.